Anton, over to you, Gunther.
Thank you very much, Francis. Mr. Jeff Nemeth is with me. Welcome, sir.
Oh, glad to be here, Gunther.
Mr. Nemeth, for starters, the obvious question is why is Nigeria and not South Africa?
Well, we're already in South Africa. We have a huge manufacturing facility here, which we supply 148 countries. We're operating at capacity here. We're really happy with how much we've grown the Ranger business around the world. We export to 148 countries. Nigeria is one of them. Nigeria is our largest export market in Africa for the Ranger, and it's got 180 million people. It's got the largest economy in Africa as of a couple years ago, and it's a great opportunity for us to expand our production footprint on the continent. Right now, we're only in South Africa from a production standpoint, and we'll be moving assembly operations into Nigeria to take advantage of the great market share that we have there already and the market potential with all the people that are there.
Is it the market share that makes the comparative cost of investment more attractive in Nigeria?
Well, obviously, economies of scale are important. So the more vehicles you can build, the easier it is to get a payback on your investment. And with Nigeria having such a potential for us and already the Ranger being so well received in Nigeria, it just makes that investment decision less risky. So it's one, as we looked around Africa at all the different potential places that we could start expanding our footprint, Nigeria, the time is right for Nigeria.
Local problems, we have quite a few of them, well documented as well. And with regards to the motor industry, are these, let me put it this way, what's your outlook for the motor industry in South Africa?
Well, you know, what's great about the motor industry in South Africa is its history, right? Ford has been here for 90 years building vehicles. Just this week, we're building our 250,000th new Ford Ranger. And, you know, that we just started building those in 2012. And just to put that in perspective, if you parked all of the Rangers we've built in South Africa bumper to bumper, mm-hmm. it would reach from Johannesburg to Cape Town. So the line of Rangers bumper to bumper. So we're extremely successful here. You know, it's not without its challenges. We've had all external factors such as, you know, labor unrest and load shedding. Like you said, the factors that everybody's aware of, and we're all working through them. And what's really important is that the unions and the government and private industry are all talking to each other and trying to find ways to come to common ground and ensure that in the future we don't have the sort of interruptions that we've seen over the last few years.
What role did the policy that Nigeria introduced, plus minus 2 years ago, regarding motor industry introduced, what is that role that did have in your decision?
Well, anytime you enter into a decision to invest like this, it's a business case, right? And so you look at the next best alternative, and the next best alternative to building Rangers in Nigeria was importing Rangers. And with the duty regimes that they've put in place, mm-hmm. With a 10% duty on imported kits, compared to a 70% duty on imported Rangers, mm-hmm. it made the decision compelling and the ability to get a decent payback on your investment compelling as well. So really when you ask what role did it have in it, it was really the catalyst. But even with that, if you didn't have the customers in Nigeria, no matter what you put the duty rates to, it wouldn't make sense. And Nigeria just happens to be a market that's large enough that between the duty rates and the sales forecasts, the business case is viable.
Earlier today, you mentioned that Nigeria will be importing many of the parts. Where are they coming from?
All the parts are going to be coming from South Africa. We'll be kitting the Rangers. It's called a kitting operation, and we'll be kitting them here in South Africa. So although we won't be building the Rangers here, mm-hmm. we will be supplying them from here. So all of our South African suppliers benefit from the additional volume. Silverton is at capacity. In fact, we can't supply all the Rangers that we have orders for.
Why didn't you expand Silverton?
It was a better economic decision to go into Nigeria at this time, given the duty structures and our ability to sell more Rangers by assembling there rather than assembling them here.
Mr. Nemeth, thank you very much for your time.
Okay, thank you. Good tour.
It's Jeff Nemeth, CEO of Ford Sub-Saharan Africa.
Thank you very much.